M.J. Shankar was an Indian serial killer and rapist, known as Psycho Shankar. Jay Shankar is accused of killing at least 19 women in a series of rapes and murders in Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, and Andhra Pradesh, India, between 2008 and 2011. He would kidnap, rape and torture his victims before murdering them. He was known to stab and mutilate victims by hacking them with a machete that he always carried with him. In 2009, Jay Shankar was arrested on 13 charges of rape. Jay Shankar escaped from jail twice and was placed in solitary confinement after a third escape attempt. In 2018, M.J. Shankar committed suicide by slicing his own throat in his solitary confinement prison cell at the Central Prison in Bangalore, India. William Supp is an American serial killer known as the Riverside Prostitute Killer and the Lake Elsinore Killer. Supp was convicted of murdering his first daughter in 1974. He abused and violently shook his infant daughter to death. Once released, he worked as a warehouse clerk for Riverside County and had close involvement with the police department. He would rape, stab, strangle, and sometimes mutilate his victims. William Supp killed 12 or more prostitutes in Riverside County, California, between 1989 and 1991. On July 19, 1995, a Riverside County jury found Supp guilty of killing 12 women and attempting to kill another, though police suspected him of being responsible for as many as 22 deaths. Supp resides on death row at San Quentin State Prison. Maury Travis was an American serial killer known as the Video Strangler. He tortured and killed prostitutes in the St. Louis area from 2000 to 2002. Travis was caught when he mailed an Expedia.com map printout to a St. Louis newspaper. In his letter to the newspaper, Travis wrote, "I'll tell you where many others are, to prove I'm real. Here's directions to number 17. Police traced the printout to Travis' home computer. He claimed to have murdered 17 women in a letter sent with the map. Investigators discovered a chamber at his residence which included instruments of torture and videotapes of Travis committing some of his crimes. Maury Travis hanged himself on June 10, 2002, in his jail cell, after being arrested for murder on June 7, 2002. John Edward Robinson is an American serial killer who was found guilty in 2003 for three murders committed in and around Kansas City, receiving the death penalty for two of them. In 2005, he admitted responsibility for five homicides in Missouri as part of a plea bargain to receive multiple life sentences without possibility of parole and avoid more death sentences. Investigators searched a storage facility where Robinson rented two garages. They found three chemical drums containing corpses. All five women were killed in the same way, by one or more blows to the head with a blunt instrument. Investigators suspect that more victims remain undiscovered. Because he made contact with most of his post-1993 victims via online chat rooms, Robinson is sometimes referred to as the internet's first serial killer. Jacobus Dirk Hertogs was a Dutch serial killer and rapist also known as Koos Hertogs. Hertogs was convicted of the abduction, torture, rape, and murder of three girls. He is suspected of killing a further 3 to 9 girls and young women in the 1970s. In 1980, Hertogs was bit on his little finger by a victim. The bite was used to help identify and lead to his arrest. During a search of his home, authorities found an attic which was provisionally furnished as a torture chamber, and blood from two of his victims. Authorities suspect he abused and eventually killed his victims in the chamber. Hertogs was sentenced to life imprisonment in 1982. In 2015, Jacobus Dirk Hertogs died of natural causes while still in custody at the Nieuwe Zeeveld prison in Vughheid, Netherlands. Daniel Owen Conahan Jr. is a convicted American murderer, rapist, and suspected serial killer. He was known to torture, strangle, rape, mutilate, dismember, and murder his victims. Conahan was convicted of one murder, but has been linked to a dozen murders, mostly of transients seeking employment, and gay men in the Charlotte County, Florida area. In what came to be known as the Hog Trail murders, Conahan surgically removed one victim's genitals after death. He would lure victims, some, by offering them money to pose nude in bondage photographs. Conahan has also been named the prime suspect in the murders of eight men, collectively referred to as the Fort Myers Eight, who were discovered in a mass grave site in 2007. Conahan is currently housed at Union Correctional Institution in Rayford, Florida. Bill Gundis was a Norwegian-American serial killer who was active in Illinois and Indiana between 1884 and 1908. Gundis is thought to have killed at least 14 people, most of whom were men she enticed to visit her rural Indiana property through personal advertisements. While some sources speculate her involvement in as many as 40 murders, Gundis seemingly died in a fire in 1908, but it is popularly believed that she faked her death. Her children had died of strychnine poisoning before the fire, and the woman's body found next to them was decapitated and reportedly smaller than Gundis' own. Her actual fate is unconfirmed. Gundis, a 6-foot-tall, 200 pounds physically strong woman, was a murder-for-profit serial killer who murdered her suitors and others to collect life insurance and other valuables. Sergei Fedorovich Tikhak was a Ukrainian police officer and serial killer who was convicted for the killings of 37 women and girls in the Soviet Union and Ukraine between 1980 and 2005. In 1984, young women and girls began to disappear across eastern Ukraine. His victims, aged between 8 and 18, were raped, suffocated, and their corpses were sexually defiled. Tikhak used his knowledge of criminal investigation procedure to mislead policemen investigating his killings. In August 2005, he attended the funeral of one of his victims. Children also in attendance claimed to have seen him with the victim shortly before her death. He was arrested and admitted to his crimes, claiming to have killed over 100 people and demanded the death penalty. Tikhak was sentenced to life imprisonment for the murder of 37 women and girls over more than two decades. Jean Weber was a French serial killer, known as the Ogress. Weber worked as a transient babysitter who strangled 10 children, including at least one of her own. Weber left home for Paris at 14 years old and later married in 1893. She was arrested for vagrancy and briefly confined to the asylum at Nanterre, but doctors pronounced her sane and set her free. In 1908, Weber was found strangling 10-year-old Marcel Poirot with a bloody handkerchief. The father had to punch her 3 times in the face before she would release the lifeless body. Held for trial on murder charges, Weber was declared insane on October 25, 1908, packed off to the asylum at Mirville. Credited with at least 10 murders, she survived 10 years in captivity before manually strangling herself in 1918. On June 23, 2000, the Childers Palace Backpackers Hostel fire killed 15 backpackers, 9 women, and 6 men, at the former Palace Hotel in the town of Childers, Queensland, Australia. The fire started shortly before 12:30 a.m. in the downstairs recreation room, and quickly spread up the walls and into the stairwell. Survivors recounted how smoke quickly filled the area and the building's power was lost. 10 guests suffered minor burns and injuries as they tried to escape from the upper level and by jumping onto the roofs of neighboring buildings. Of the 15 who died in the fire, 7 were British, 3 were Australian, 2 were from the Netherlands, and 1 each from Ireland, Japan, and South Korea. Robert Paul Long was arrested and charged with 2 counts of murder and 1 count of arson. He was later sentenced to life imprisonment. Dmitry Bakshiev and his wife Natalia, accused of serving a stuffed and decorated human head as dinner, and pickling human remains in jars after luring their victims from dating sites, Dmitry lost his mobile phone, on which there were pictures of him with human remains, even holding a severed human head in his mouth. The phone was later found by road workers and immediately reported to the police. Police also discovered a picture dating back to 1999 that showed a human face being prepared as a dish, surrounded by oranges. Natalia Bakshiva was sentenced to 10 years in a penal colony and 1.5 years in prison. Dmitry Bakshiev was sentenced to 12 years and 2 months in a maximum security prison. On February 16, 2020, Dmitry Bakshiev died of untreated type 1 diabetes while in custody. Jürgen Bartsch began killing at the age of 15. His first victim was Klaus Jung in 1962. His next victim was Peter Fuchs, who was killed in 1965. He persuaded all of his victims to accompany him into an abandoned air raid shelter where he forced them to undress and then sexually abused them. He dismembered his first four victims. His intended fifth victim, 15-year-old Peter Fress, escaped by burning through his bindings with a candle that Bartsch had left burning after leaving the shelter. Bartsch was arrested in 1966 and agreed to voluntary castration on April 28, 1976. In order to avoid lifetime incarceration, the doctors of Egilborn State Hospital chose a castration methodology that accidentally resulted in Bartsch's death. He had been intoxicated with a halothane overdose during surgery. Roger Kipp was an American serial killer and rapist, known as the I-5 Strangler. Kipp killed 7 women between 1977 and 1987, 6 along I-5 near Sacramento, and 1 in Walnut Creek, California. Kipp kidnapped his victims, bound, duct-taped the mouths and cut open their clothes in irregular shapes with scissors that had belonged to his mother. Kipp also cut off most of the hair of his victims to remove the duct tape. Sometimes he garroted his victims with the parachute cord with which he skydived. Then, he raped them and strangled them to death. It took detectives 34 years to find the body of one of his victims. Kipp was sentenced to life imprisonment in 1991. In 2021, Roger Reese Kipp was strangled to death in his cell while still in prison. Daniel Blank is an American serial killer who killed at least 6 people from 1996 to 1997. In 1997, Blank was arrested on 3 charges of first-degree murder. He has a learning disability that hampers his verbal abilities and understanding of abstract concepts. Blank was diagnosed as having schizoaffective paranoia disorder. He confessed to 6 murders, including a double bludgeoning of an elderly couple. Blank was sentenced to death in 1999. He was granted a new trial in 2006 because of a clerical error during court procedures in a Boyles Parish in 2000, entered the plea in exchange for the life sentence. The St. John the Baptist Parish District Attorney's Office was seeking the death penalty for Blank in the murder of Joan Brock, a 55-year-old LaPlace woman he killed in her backyard. Wayne Bowden was a Canadian serial killer and rapist known as the Vampire Rapist. Bowden killed 4 women between 1968 and 1971 in Montreal and Calgary, Canada. He would always leave bite marks on the breasts of his 5 female victims. All victims had been found naked and strangled to death in their apartments, but there were no signs of any struggle, earning the nickname the Vampire Rapist. A cast made of Bowden's teeth demonstrated 29 points of similarity between the bite marks on one of his victims and his teeth. Bowden was the first murderer to be convicted in North America based on odontological evidence. Bowden received 4 life sentences in 1972. In 2006, Wayne Bowden died from skin cancer at Kingston General Hospital after being confined in the hospital for 6 weeks. Margaret Waters was an English murderer. Waters was born in 1835 and lived in Brixton. She was known for baby farming, the practice of taking in other women's children for money, a practice which often resulted in infanticide. Margaret turned to baby farming in 1864 after the death of her husband to make ends meet. Waters drugged and starved the infants in her care, and is believed to have killed at least 19 children, charged with 5 counts of willful murder, as well as neglect and conspiracy. Waters was convicted of murdering an infant named John Walter Cowan. The arresting police officer wrote of his findings at Margaret's house: "Some half dozen little infants lay together on a sofa, filthy, starving, and stupefied by laudanum." She was hanged on October 11, 1870 at Horsemonger Lane Jail in London. Anthony Allen Shore was an American serial killer and pedophile rapist known as the Tourniquet Killer. Because of his use of a ligature with either a toothbrush or bamboo stick to tighten or loosen the ligature, Shore is responsible for the murders of one woman and 4 young girls. He was convicted of strangling a woman with an unusual ligature in 1992 and confessed to killing 3 girls. Shore was also convicted of molesting his 2 daughters, Tiffany and Amber. As a result, he was required to provide police with a DNA sample. Detectives pulled Carmen Del Estrada's case from the cold files and tested DNA evidence from underneath Carmen's fingernails. In 2003, the results came back a match to Shore's genetic profile. He was executed by lethal injection at Texas State Penitentiary at Huntsville, Huntsville Unit in Huntsville, Texas, U.S. Richard Fran Buchenwald was an American serial killer and arsonist who committed his crimes in Monmouth County, New Jersey, known as the Thrill Killer. Buchenwald killed at least 9 people in Monmouth County, New Jersey between 1958 and 1983. He is suspected in at least 2 other murders. One of his victims was shot 4 times in the head. One of his victims was shot 5 times in the head. Police found a victim's corpse, cut into 3 pieces and buried in the yard of a house in the Charleston section of Staten Island. She was not alone. The shallow grave held the remains of another girl. Buchenwald was sentenced to death. His sentence was commuted to 4 terms of life. In 2008, Richard Buchenwald died of natural causes at the St. Francis Medical Center in Trenton, New Jersey. Eric Edgar Cook, nicknamed the Night Caller, was an Australian serial killer. From 1958 to 1963, he terrorized the city of Perth, Western Australia by committing 22 violent crimes, 8 of which resulted in deaths. The various shootings had been carried out with several different rifles. Victims had been stabbed with knives and scissors, and hit with an axe. One victim was shot dead after answering a knock on the door. Several were killed after waking while Cook was robbing their homes. 2 were shot while sleeping without their homes being disturbed. Another victim was strangled with the cord from her bedside lamp, her dead body raped, then dragged to a neighbor's lawn, where she was violated with an empty whiskey bottle which was left cradled in her arms. Cook was hanged at 8 a.m. on October 26, 1964 in Fremantle Prison. Adolfo Constanzo was a Cuban-American serial killer and cult leader in Matamoros, Tamaulipas, Mexico. The cult was involved in multiple ritualistic killings in Matamoros, including the murder of Mark Kilroy, an American student abducted, tortured, and killed in the area in 1989. Officers raided the ranch and discovered Constanzo's cauldron, which contained various items such as a dead black cat and a human brain. 15 mutilated corpses were dug up at the ranch, one of them Kilroy's. Kilroy was killed by Constanzo with a machete chop to the back of the neck when Kilroy tried to escape. Police cornered Costanzo and 4 of his followers in a dilapidated Mexico City apartment. Determined not to go to prison, Costanzo ordered one of the disciples to shoot him. He was dead when the police finally broke in. Peter Manuel was an American Scottish serial killer known as the Beast of Birkinshaw. Manuel was convicted of murdering 7 people across Lanarkshire between 1956 and 1958. He is believed to have killed 2 other victims. He was known to rob, torture, rape, and murder his victims. He would keep personal items from the victim after the crime. Manuel was one of the last prisoners to be hanged in Scotland. After a sensational trial in which he conducted his own defense, in 1958, Manuel was convicted of the murders of 7 people. One murder case was thrown out of court and another was attributed to him but was never proven. Peter Manuel died on July 11, 1958, age 31, executed by hanging at Home Prison Barlinnie, Riddrie, Glasgow, Scotland. Enriqueta Marti was a self-proclaimed witch that abducted, prostituted, murdered, and made potions with the bodies of small children that she sold in Barcelona. Remains of 12 different children were identified in her home, but she is believed to have murdered more. Marti was also questioned about the presence of bones, human remains, creams, potions, poultices, ointments, blood bottles, as well as the boning knife. Marti confessed that she had prostituted a girl of 17 years, and had also performed abortions, but she never confessed to killing anyone. Marti was imprisoned to await trial. She tried to commit suicide by slashing her wrists. People wanted her to face trial and execution by the garrote. Enriqueta Marti was murdered in prison by fellow inmates while awaiting trial in 1913. Luis Garavito, also known as the Beast, is a Colombian serial killer, sex offender, pedophile, and necrophile. He began a series of torture rapes on minors aged 6 to 16 in 1980. Garavito was estimated to have killed a minimum of 200 minors before committing the murders of an additional 189 minors in the early 90s, and a further 4 murders in during the summer of 1998. Apprehended on April 22, 1999, the judicial body ruled that all Garavito's sentences total 1,853 years and 9 days in jail. Garavito is confirmed to have murdered at least 193 minors in total. His murders of 23 minors and 5 adults would raise his murder victim count to 221. James Dale Ritchie was an American serial killer. Throughout 2016, Ritchie murdered upwards of 5 individuals in and around Anchorage, Alaska, most of whom were in parks or along bike paths. He always committed his murders at night, often around midnight or a short time after. He was known to abuse alcohol and drugs. He was shot during a gunfight with Anchorage Police Department at the corner of 5th Avenue and Cordova Street in Anchorage, Alaska, U.S. Following Ritchie's death, the cold python on his person was sent to the Alaska Crime Lab where it was confirmed to have been the murder weapon responsible for the deaths of Brianna Foisey, Jason Netter Sr., Trevian Kendall Thompson, Kevin Turner, and Brian DeHusson. The investigative task force had not considered Ritchie a suspect, due to his lack of run-ins with the law over the decade prior. Thomas Neil Crean was a Scottish-Canadian serial killer known as the Lambeth Poisoner. In 1881, Crean started his killing spree. Crean poisoned one man and several women with chloroform and strychnine, attempting to frame and then blackmail other men for the murders in some cases. He murdered up to 10 people in 3 countries, Ontario, Chicago, and London, targeting mostly lower-class women, prostitutes and pregnant women seeking abortions. He married Flora Brooks in 1876, one of Thomas's possible victims. He had no children, 2 possible unborn children from 2 possible victims. He was convicted and sentenced to death. Thomas Neil Crean was executed by hanging at age 42, in 1892 at Newgate Prison in London, England. Paul Kenneth Bernardo is a Canadian serial killer and rapist, known as the Schoolgirl Killer and the Scarborough Rapist. Bernardo raped and murdered at least three minors between 1990 and 1992. Bernardo attacked most of his victims after stalking them as they got off of public transportation buses in Scarborough, Canada. He was known to torture, strangle, stalk, rape, mutilate, and murder his victims. Bernardo gained worldwide media attention when he raped, tortured, and murdered two Ontario teenage girls with the assistance of his wife, Carla Homolka. Homolka and Bernardo were arrested in 1993. In 1995, Paul Kenneth Bernardo was convicted of a number of offenses, including the two first-degree murders, and was sentenced to life in prison. Yukio Yamaji was a Japanese serial killer who killed his 50-year-old mother with a metal baseball bat in Yamaguchi City, Yamaguchi Prefecture at age 16 on July 29, 2000. He called the police and was arrested on July 31, 2000, imprisoned, and then paroled in 2003. In 2005, on November 17, Yamaji raped and murdered a 27-year-old woman and her 19-year-old sister with a knife. In the Niwa, Osaka, he then set fire to their apartment and fled. He was arrested on December 5, 2005. While in custody, he stated to the Osaka police, "I could not forget the feeling when I killed my mother, and wanted to see human blood." He was sentenced to death. He was executed in 2009. Tommy Lynn Sells was an American serial killer. He was convicted of one murder for which he received the death penalty and was eventually executed. Authorities believe he committed a total of 22 murders, and he claimed on various occasions to have murdered over 70 people. Kayleen Harris, 13, was sexually assaulted, stabbed 16 times, and her throat slashed. Deborah Harris, 31, and her 8-year-old daughter Embria Halliburton were both killed after Sells broke into their house at night and raped Harris. She was stabbed repeatedly with her own kitchen knife, which was left in her chest. Halliburton was stabbed 3 times after she witnessed Sells murder her mother. Retired Texas Ranger John Allen said, "We did confirm 22. I know there's more. I know there's a lot more. Obviously, we won't ever know." Terry Rasmussen was an American serial killer known as the Chameleon Killer. During his crimes as a serial killer, he was known to torture, rape, mutilate, and murder his victims. The Bear Brook murders and Allenstown barrel murders refer to 4 dismembered female murder victims found in barrels. 2 discovered in 1985, and 2 in 2000, at Bear Brook State Park in Allenstown, New Hampshire. In 2002, Rasmussen was charged with the murder of his common-law wife, Yoon Sun Jun. Her body was found dismembered and covered in cat litter inside a crawl space at his home. In 2003, Rasmussen was sentenced to 15 years in prison. Terry Rasmussen died in 2010, while still in prison. April 27, 2023, there are calls for the woman described as Australia's worst female serial killer to be released immediately after the Director of Public Prosecutions accepted new scientific evidence casting doubt over on the mother's guilt. Kathleen Falbeek has been found guilty of killing her 4 children, but the senior barrister assisting an inquiry into her conviction said there was reasonable doubt surrounding the conviction. University of British Columbia's Emma Cunliffe said she believed Falbeek should be paroled today. The COM2G114R genetic variant impacting the calcium-binding calmodulin protein, identified in Falbeek and her 2 daughters, was a reasonably possible cause of Sarah and Laura's deaths, according to cardiology and genetics experts. Myocarditis, an inflammation of the heart, was also a reasonable possible cause of Laura's death. J. John Floyd Thomas is an American serial killer and rapist known as the West Side Rapist and the Southland Strangler. Thomas has one of the longest criminal careers in the U.S. The first wave of killings claimed the lives of 17 women ranging in age from the 50s to the 90s. The murders stopped in 1978, the same year a witness copied down Mr. Thomas's car license number after he raped a woman in Pasadena and was sent to jail. The second wave began after his release in 1983. Five more elderly white women were raped and strangled in the Claremont area. On April 1, 2011, Thomas pleaded guilty to the 7 counts of murder as part of a deal to avoid the death sentence. Investigators have said Thomas is possibly one of the most prolific serial killers in the city's history. He was sentenced to life imprisonment without the possibility of parole. Alexander Bychkov is a Russian serial killer convicted for the murder of 9 men in Belinsky, Penza Oblast. Between 2009 and 2012, Bychkov described in his personal diary how he killed 11 men and confessed to cannibalizing organs and body parts of his victims. He would lure victims to his home or another secluded place where he would kill them with a hammer or knife, and then dismembered the corpses. The remains were buried in the backyard of his house or in the city's rubbish dump. The first dismembered corpse was found in the spring of 2010. In September of the same year, 2 more dismembered corpses were found. Upon being questioned by police, Bychkov claimed that he ate livers, hearts, and muscles of his victims. Bychkov was sentenced to life imprisonment at FKU, IK5, on the island of Onyany in the Vologda region of Russia. Yavuzya Bishiyoglu is a Turkish serial killer and arsonist nicknamed the Screwdriver Killer. He is considered the most prolific serial killer in Turkish history, being responsible for the deaths of 18 people between 1994 and 2002 according to police records, or as many as 40 according to eyewitnesses and his relatives. He hated women due to his unsuccessful marriage. He killed 3 people and injured 2 more severely with a screwdriver in Korlu. Yavuzya had previously been a patient at several psychiatric hospitals in Turkey. He was given a medical examination and was found fully criminally liable for the offenses he committed. He is believed to be the serial killer with the highest known victim count in Turkey. He was apprehended on December 24, 2002. Yavuzya Bishiyoglu has been preventively detained at the Tekirdağ prison since 2013. Cynthia Kaufman was the partner in crime of James Gregory Marlowe. She was born St. Louis, Missouri. She abandoned her husband and kids, traveled around together with Marlowe, randomly killing young girls. They strangled 4 such victims to death, 2 of which were brutally sexually assaulted in October to November 1986. They were arrested on November 14, 1986. Kaufman admits to committing the murders, but insists she suffered from battered woman syndrome. They were put on trial in July 1989, and in 1990 sentenced to death. Kaufman being the first woman to receive a death sentence in California since the reinstatement of the death penalty in 1977. A further trial in 1992 convicted her for another murder with a sentence of life imprisonment. She is still on death row. Peter Bryan is an English serial killer and diagnosed paranoid schizophrenic. He was known to commit acts of cannibalism, strangle, mutilate, and murder his victims. Bryan was preventively detained in a mental institution, Rampton Hospital. After killing a shop assistant with a hammer in 1993, Bryan was transferred to an open psychiatric ward at Newham General Hospital after psychiatrists noted his continued improvement. Upon his transfer in 2004, Bryan killed a friend and later confessed to dismembering the body and cooking the brains in butter and eating them. Bryan was held at Belmarsh Prison and later transferred to Broadmoor Hospital where he killed a fellow mental patient, declaring that he did not eat him solely because he was caught first. In 2005, Peter Bryan was sentenced to life in prison at Broadmoor Hospital in Berkshire, England. David Carpenter is an American serial killer known as the Trailside Killer. Carpenter murdered women hikers on San Francisco area hiking trails between 1979 and 1981. He would stalk, rape, and murder hikers by shooting the victims in state parks near San Francisco, California. He was convicted of an attempted murder in 1960. In 1970, Carpenter was convicted for kidnapping. After his release, he was a suspect in the Zodiac murders, although he was eventually cleared. In 1984, he attacked at least 10 individuals, with two attempted victims, Stephen Hartle and Louis Rinna, surviving. Carpenter was sentenced to death. He received a second death sentence in 1988. David Carpenter remains on death row at the San Quentin State Prison in San Quentin, California. Wolfgang Schmidt is a German serial killer known as the Pink Giant. Schmidt killed five women and a three-month-old baby from 1989 to 1991. He was known to commit acts of necrophilia, strangle, rape, and murder his victims. In 2009, Schmidt underwent a hormone treatment for gender reassignment and is now a trans woman. He was arrested after two joggers found him masturbating in the woods while wearing a bra. Wolfgang Schmidt was sentenced to a 15-year sentence at a psychiatric hospital in Brandenburg an der Havel, Brandenburg, Germany. In 1992, an application for a name change to Beat Schmidt was met by the court in 2001. Since 2009, Schmidt has undergone a hormone treatment for gender reassignment. In 2010, Schmidt was investigated for raping and causing another transgender inmate to attempt suicide. Robledo Puch, also known as the Black Angel, is an Argentinian serial killer. He was known to rob, strangle, rape, mutilate, and murder his victims. He is convicted for 11 murders, 1 attempt, 17 robberies, 1 violation, 1 attempt of violation, 1 sexual abuse, 2 kidnappings, and 2 thefts. He was sentenced to life imprisonment to be served in the high-security jail of Sierra Chica near the city of Olavarria. On May 27, 2008, Puch asked to be paroled, but a judge denied his petition considering he is a threat to society. In July 2017, Carlos Eduardo Robledo Puch had spent more than 45 years in prison and became the longest-serving prisoner in Argentina. Kenneth Alan McDuff was an American serial killer. He would rape, torture, strangle, and shoot his victims. He was convicted in 1966 of murdering 16-year-old Edna Sullivan, her boyfriend, 17-year-old Robert Brand, and Brand's cousin, 15-year-old Mark Dunham, who was visiting from California. They were all strangers whom McDuff abducted after noticing Sullivan. McDuff repeatedly raped her before strangling her with a broomstick so violently it broke her neck. McDuff was given 3 death sentences that were reduced to life imprisonment consequently to the 1972 U.S. Supreme Court ruling Furman v. Georgia. He was paroled in 1989 and went on to kill again. He was executed in 1998 by lethal injection, and is suspected to have been responsible for many other killings. Israel Keyes was an American serial killer, rapist, arsonist, burglar, and bank robber. He was known to rob, strangle, rape, mutilate, and murder. Keyes murdered 3 confirmed victims and was linked to another 11 victims in 4 separate states. The earliest crime to which Keyes admitted was the violent sexual assault of a teenage girl in Oregon sometime between 1996 and 1998. Keyes burglarized 20 to 30 homes and robbed several banks between 2001 and 2012. He may be linked to as many as 11 deaths. Keyes planned murders long ahead of time, usually killed far from home and never in the same area twice. Keyes committed suicide on December 2, 2012, age 34, via self-inflicted wrist cuts and strangulation at Anchorage Correctional Complex. Mohammad Bijay was an Iranian serial killer, rapist, and necrophile known as the Tehran Desert Vampire. Bijay raped and killed at least 54 boys and teenagers. He would stun his victims with blows from a stone to the head. He raped and buried the bodies in a shallow grave. In 2004, early in the case, 16 police officers were arrested on charges of derailing the investigations by refusing to identify the murderer earlier. Bijay said that if he was not arrested, he would kill 100 children. On 16 March 2005 in Pakdasht, in front of a crowd of about 5,000, Bijay was handcuffed to an iron post where he received his lashings. The mother of one of the victims put a blue nylon rope around his neck, and he was hoisted about 10 meters in the air by a crane until he died. Serial killer Patricia Allinson, aka the Deadly Magnolia, was active for 18 years between 1974 to 1991, known to have 3 confirmed and 3 possible victims. In 1974, Allinson goaded her husband into killing his parents. After he was sentenced to prison, she poisoned his grandparents, all in an effort to gain $500,000 inheritance. After serving a short prison term, she poisoned an elderly couple that she was caring for, but this time she enlisted the help of her daughter, released from prison in 1999. In 2008, Allinson, age 70, was arrested and charged with doctor shopping for more than 3,700 painkillers. She was charged with 3 counts of unauthorized distribution. She entered a plea agreement with a sentence of probation only. Known as the Donnybrook serial killer, Zikode murdered 18 people and attempted to murder another 11 over a period of 2 years in the rural Natal Midlands town of Donnybrook in South Africa. All his victims were between 20 and 30. His modus operandi was to kick open the door of his victim's house, shoot the men in the head and drag the women to nearby plantations where he would rape them repeatedly, sometimes for as long as 5 hours, then kill them. If they resisted, he would shoot them first and commit necrophilia. Mike Lengue, 21, was arrested on September 29, 1995. On January 7, 1997, a high court judge sentenced 23-year-old Zikode to 140 years in prison, including 5 life sentences for a 6-month rape and murder rampage. James Miller was an Australian serial killer who is known to have committed the Truro murders. The Truro murders are a series of murders of young women in bushland east of the town of Truro in South Australia. Miller and his accomplice, Christopher Worrell, a rapist just released, who was subsequently killed in a car crash, picked up the victims, most of whom were hitchhikers, raped and murdered them. It appears that all had been strangled, often using a nylon cord. Though there was a suspicion that the last of the victims had been buried alive, Miller argued that he never engaged in any murders directly. He claims Worrell acted alone. Miller was found guilty of 6 of the 7 murders and sentenced to 6 consecutive terms of life imprisonment with a non-parole period of 35 years. He died of cancer in 2008. Elizabeth Wedelhofer is a Canadian serial killer and former registered nurse who confessed to murdering 8 senior citizens and attempting to murder 6 others in southwestern Ontario between 2007 and 2016, with a total of 14 victims either killed or injured by her actions. The first case in which she injected a patient with enough insulin to directly cause death was on August 11, 2007. Wedelhofer admitted that she knew the difference between right and wrong, but she was visited by surges she could not control. She said, "God or the devil or whatever, wanted me to do it." After one murder, she felt the surging, and then heard her own laughter afterwards, which was really, it was like a cackling from the pit of hell. In March 2018, she was transferred from Grand Valley to an unspecified secure facility in Montreal to receive medical treatment. Marcel Petiot was a French medical doctor and serial killer. He was convicted of multiple murders after the discovery of the remains of 23 people in the basement of his home in Paris during World War II. He injected his victims with cyanide. He then took all their valuables and disposed of the bodies. At first, Petiot dumped the bodies in the Seine, but he later destroyed the bodies by submerging them in quicklime or incinerating them. He is suspected of the murder of about 60 victims during his lifetime, although the true number remains unknown. On March 11, 1944, Petiot's neighbors in Rue Elie-sur complained to police about a foul stench in the area. In the backyard, enough body parts were found to account for at least 10 victims. On May 25, 1946, Petiot was beheaded and buried at Ivory Cemetery. A mother accused of strangling her three children to death says she heard voices in her head before her attempted murder-suicide. Lindsay Clancy, 32, from Massachusetts, U.S., appeared at Plymouth District Court via Zoom from her hospital bed to hear the charges against her yesterday. The nurse faces three counts of murder and three counts each of strangulation, assault, and battery with a dangerous weapon. Prosecutors allege she strangled her three children at their home before she allegedly slit her wrists and neck, and then jumped 20 feet from the second floor window. Each child was lying face down on the floor and had an exercise band tied around their necks. According to prosecutors, Mrs. Clancy told a psychologist she heard a male voice telling her to kill her three children and herself before the attempted murder-suicide. She remains in hospital. John Strafen was an English serial killer who killed two young girls in the summer of 1951. On July 15, 1951, Strafen saw Brenda Goddard gathering flowers and offered to show her a better place. He lifted Brenda over a fence, after which she fell and hit her head on a stone. She was unconscious when he strangled her. On August 8, Strafen was at the cinema when he met 9-year-old Cicely Batstone. He then went on a bus to the outskirts of Bath. There he murdered her by strangulation. Strafen killed his third victim after escaping from the mental hospital where he was being held for the first two murders. Strafen's sentence was commuted to life imprisonment. John Strafen died at Franklin Prison in 2007 at the age of 77. He had been in prison for a British record of 55 years and is currently the longest serving prisoner in British legal history. Matthew James Harris is an Australian serial killer who strangled three people in and around Wagga Wagga, New South Wales, Australia, in October and November 1998. Victims were a friend's brother, a female friend, and a male neighbor of Harris. One victim was forced into a bath with Harris, as he strangled her, and held her under the water for up to 4 minutes at a time. Harris overdosed twice on heroin a few days after his last murder, and again in the early hours of December 1, 1998, which led to his arrest. In 1999, Matthew James Harris was sentenced to 28 years in prison. On December 20, 2000, the sentences were substituted for two terms of life imprisonment plus an additional 40 years. Sunil Kumar is an alleged Indian serial killer and rapist known as the Gurugram serial killer. Kumar confessed to killing at least 15 victims from 2011 to 2018. He would visit community kitchens and offer sweets to lure little girls from poor families. Kumar picked isolated locations prior to the attacks. He would leave the body at the same location. Kumar was arrested in 2018 at his sister's house in a village near Jhansi. He told police he would wear the same shirt while committing the crimes, his lucky blue shirt. He confessed to crimes in Delhi, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, and Madhya Pradesh. In 2018, police recovered the remains of a 5-year-old girl scattered under a gulmohar tree. The girl was an unfound body Sunil Kumar previously confessed to.